Now we're going to make a handy tool belt for the girls or for the guys, for the garden, for the barbecue or even for the home. And it's great for the kids as well. And what is the best thing, I think, about making something like this is this, because we're using old jeans. Never throw away your jeans. The more you've worn them, the softer the fabric gets, and it's a lovely fabric to work with. But if this kind of thing happens and you think about time they went in the bin or to the charity shop, just have a think twice, because you've got a whole lot of lovely fabric. So I've chopped the legs off. Now, the rest of the jeans could be a pair of shorts now, but I'm not going to throw this away. This is what I'm going to make the apron out of. I'll need both legs, and I'll give those a quick measure for you. I've actually chopped off about 19 inches. I'm going to make that shorter because I don't want the hole in those. So I'll cut that down and they'll actually be about 17 inches across. And that's going to be the width of my apron. One of the legs is going to be for the back of the apron. The other one I'm going to cut down even more, and that's going to be pockets on the front of the apron. And then for the belt, or for the tie around the waist, I should say, this is it's a handbag handle strapping. You don't need to hem it, which is the beauty of this one. And you can just sew it straight on the top. But it's quite thick and robust and in keeping with the denim that I'm using. And then I've got a second piece here, which I'm going to use to make little loops across the top of my apron, so that I can put tools in there and hang them off if I so wanted to. So I can either use the pockets, or I can use those, or use both. And that measures around about a yard, just over a yard in length. So first thing we need to do is make sure that the back of our apron is cut square. Jeans, if you've got flares or if you've got a bootleg shape, you will need to cut into them to make sure they're perfectly square. These are a men's jean, so they are actually square. They would have had a straight leg, but do make sure, otherwise it's going to be a little bit wonky. So I'm going to leave one side of my jeans intact, that's just folded over. The other side of my jeans here, I'm going to cut that off, keeping it as long as I can. And again, keeping this straight, so I can use my board for this. So, and then cut the edge off. It's quite thick if you're using a rotary cutter, so I'll just cut through the end bit with the scissors. And then I'll need to cut that hole off the end as well. Now for my pocket, I quite like to see the stitching on the top. So I've pressed the thick seam, the top seam, so that's going to sit right across the top of my pocket. Again, that has to be on a straight edge of your jeans. If it's not straight, then you're going to have to cut that off. But that's going to sit around about just over halfway on the back of my apron. So I need to put a mark so that they measure the same at the side. That's where I'm going to cut. And a mark where I'm going to cut across the bottom here, which will be there. And the rest of this denim is going to be saved for another project. Right, so there's the back of my apron. There's the pockets. That's the pocket that's going to go on the front of my apron. And the way that I'm going to do it, I'm going to sew the pocket to the front of the apron first of all, just to hold it in place. And I'll put some dividers down here as well. So I'll bring up my machine. Just make sure all of those are lined up. You can pin that if you wanted to. And this is purely to hold the pieces together. You won't see these stitches. So I'm going to hold both sides together. And then we'll sew some dividers into that pocket. So I'm just going to mark where they need to be. Have as many as you like. You could have one long pocket if that suits the kind of tools you're going to use in here. I'm going to put four. So I'm going to draw a line with a water erasable pen. And just put four lines here. Make the end pockets a little bit wider because there's going to be a seam that they disappear into. But it doesn't matter if these are all the same. Maybe you've got smaller ones. If it's going to be maybe for a child with their pencils, you could put lots of small pockets. They can put a pen in each one of those. Depends what you're going to use it for. And then I'm going to sew straight down those lines. Take it easy when you're sewing over the big bumpy bit, because there's lots of seams here. A denim needle would be a good idea. They're a little bit stronger than regular needles. And just sew a line straight down. If you don't want to see that, then use a blue thread. But I'm using a contrasting thread so you can see where I've been. Where you start at the top of the pockets, go backwards and forwards a few times. And that's going to strengthen the pocket so it doesn't come undone when you put things in it. Just trim away the loose ends. And that's my final pocket. Right, the next bit is going to be putting the loops across the top. So I remember where my fabric folded, so that's how my apron's looking at the moment. And I want my tape to go across here. So I'll just make sure I've got the shorter piece. It's about a yard and a half to go around the waist, but cut that down to the measurement that you want. Measure yourself first. And this is going to go across here, just on one side. So open it up. And I'm just going to pin one end for now. And then make some loops. And pin. Again, as many of those as you like, as big as you like, or small as you like, as far apart as you like. If you're going to be hanging tools in here like hammers and pliers, then you may need them a little bit wider. So just trying to keep that in a straight line. And you can vary the size of those as well. You can maybe do one very big one if you know you've got something very large that you want to carry, or keep them flat if it's something quite slim, like maybe your scissors. Okay, and then we'll sew those in place. Right, so that's how we're looking now. So my loops to hold my tools are all there. And now we can trim off the end of the tape. There, that's how we're looking. Next thing to do is to sew all the way around. So I'll turn everything inside out. And my hole for turning, I'm going to leave at the thin side, not on top of the pockets. And the reason for that is it's going to be easier because I'll top stitch this when I turn it the other way out, and it's easier to top stitch over the thinner fabrics rather than the thicker. So it will be quite a small hole for turning, but it'll be good. So away we go. Line up all of those pieces so they're all together. You can pin that if it makes it easier. Just going over the very thick section a couple of times, just to make it a little bit more secure. And then just like when you turn anything inside out, cushion covers or the like, I'm just going to cut across those corners, and that cuts down on the amount of bulk. You won't get a perfect point with all of these layers of denim, but that makes it a little bit easier. And then it's turning time. And I've only left a small hole to do this, but be fine. Right, so that's how we're looking. I'll give that a press in just a second. Where the opening was at the side, I'm simply going to fold in those edges. If you can't get all of this bulk underneath your machine, then sew that little bit by hand. I'll just pin that for now. Like so. So that opening needs to be closed. If you sew by hand, you don't actually see the stitches, which is quite nice. Sew it from the other side. And I am going to put the belt over the top, so that'll hide a lot of this as well. And then all we need to do is to put the belt on. So find the center point by folding in half. And we're going to sew that just straight across the top of your belt here. So pin that if you want to. Keep it as straight as you can. When I come to the end of the apron, I'm going to sew around in a box. So it gets a little bit fiddly around here, but it's worth it. And then straight down the other side. Just so that it looks a little bit neater. And then we're nearly done. So there you go. I'll go and press that in just a second. And then you've got a really useful tool belt for the guys, for the girls, for the kids, for whatever you want to use it for.